So my name is Henrik Schumann-Olsen and I'm CTO of Zivid. And I'm going to discuss in this webinar about the role of the 3D camera in pick and place operations. Okay, so what is Zivid? Here is a short presentation of our company. You can see our product portfolio. We are a so-called pure play 3D camera company. Our products is the CV1 Plus, which is in three variants, the small, medium, large. And then now recently released is our newest camera, the CV2. And then what do I mean with pure play 3D camera company? I mean that we are focusing entirely on the cameras. So that means our customers are system integrators or OEMs that creates the full picking cells. And then we provide them with the best camera. So what does that mean for us? It means that we focus on the quality of the cameras and the image quality that they produce. So that's our entire focus, meaning we put a lot of effort into creating the best point clouds out there. So that is something we want to look at in this presentation and what it means for your applications. Okay. So if we look at the fundamentals of a pick and place operation, we have three important aspects. So the first is about detection. So obviously you want to detect all the objects that are relevant for your application. And that depends on what types of application it is, but you want to detect everything. And then it has to be accurate and reliable, regardless of type of objects, if it's different shape, size, material, and or surfaces. And then when you have detected the objects, you want to be able to pick them. And you want to do that accurately as well. You don't want to crash. And when you pick the objects, you want to be assured that you're not accidentally dropping them. And then at last, dependent about your application, there can be different requirements for placing the object. But regardless, you want to be able to place object without crashing or destroying the objects in general. Okay, so let's look at the 3D camera. And what role does the 3D camera play in all of this? Obviously, it plays a central role in the detection. You need a 3D camera to see the objects, and then you also need a vision algorithm that can detect certain forms, and that could be, for instance, CAD-based, or it could be an AI or similar. So you need these things. But then there is something that's underestimated in the industry, and that is the importance of the 3D camera in regards to pick and place operations as well. And I'm going to cover this in more detail in the presentation, and I think it will give a lot of good insights for everyone. Okay, so let's look at some sample pick and place applications. So we have piece picking, and that is in a warehouse logistics setting where a robot is picking various items, individual SKUs they are called, for automated order fulfillment. And then in the manufacturing environment, we have bin picking, which is in general a bin randomly filled with objects. And the robot is picking each individual objects. Maybe it's at the entry of the factory, so it's placing it on feeders, conveyors, or sorter, or similar. And then very closely related to bin picking, we have machine tending, which is the same kind of picking operation, but then you pick to load or unload machines, and that could, for instance, be a CNC machine, and you want to place the object inside that machine for processing. And obviously, then you need more accuracy in the placing operation. Okay, so if we deep dive a little more on these in these picking application, what are the main challenges? So in bin picking, one of the challenges is the emptying the whole bin. The objects can be located differently and they're hard to image, maybe they're shiny, so that could be problematic. And in piece picking, it's all about SKU coverage. And with SKU coverage, we mean the ability to detect reliably and pick all types of objects that you meet in the warehouse. And if you ask, is that possible? The answer is no. Today, state of the art, unfortunately, is not good enough in order to pick all the objects. So the SKU coverage is quite low. An example of that is Amazon. You can think now during COVID, they have hired approximately almost 200,000 people, and now there is around a million people picking in the warehouses out there. So in principle, still humans are doing what we're trying to solve with robots. So there is lots of work to do. So let's look into some of the main challenges into that. So this is a typical image presented to a robot. And this is a bin in consumer, where there's lots of consumer goods here. So this could be in a warehouse. And this is a camera, a low-end stereo camera that is widely used in the industry. So this is what we present to the robots out there. And when you look at this image, this is a 3D image, you clearly understand that it's not particularly easily, not for us as humans, this is easy. I mean, it's very hard to see. I mean, you can see some of the objects, yes, but most of it is just a blur. Okay, so we want to improve the camera quality. So this image here is from a high-end stereo camera. That is also used by a lot of piece picking applications out there. So of course, what you see here is it's better than the previous one. It's slower, it's 400 milliseconds compared to 66, but still there are problems. So let's, for instance, zoom in on this part here. And if I look at that detailed image, then, and I ask you, can you pick one of these objects? Then put yourself in the robot's position. Would you be able to pick this? And I think you all know the answer. So, okay, keep that in mind. Let's jump over to manufacturing. So this is an image from some metal parts that are, okay, they are not jammed together in a bin in this, they are actually singulated. But still, even when they are singulated, this image shows the problems. So this is the same camera, the high-end stereo camera. And you can see here that there is groups of objects that blend together and become quite hard to distinguish. And if this was all in a bin, yeah, you can imagine how that would be. Some are easier, they are better separated. So some as possible, but there are still challenges. Okay, in manufacturing, many use lasers. So this is from a high-end laser structured light system, and the quality improves clearly, but still there is the resolution is low, and when the objects are quite shiny, you get artifacts, and it's almost impossible to understand what's going on here. And the cylinders here, they also start to get some reflection artifacts. The speed here is also slower, still a decent speed. And of course, if you increase this to much longer acquisition, then you could get better data, but then you would also at some point, it will be too slow for the cycle time needed in this industry. Okay, so this is what we work on in Zivid. We want to give the robots more human-like vision, because in order for the robots to take over human tasks, they need to see more like humans. So we address that in all our designs. And in regards to detection, which was one of the three things we looked at, we believe that you need to be able to see all the details, and you need to see with confidence. So that means you need to be able to see all the tiny, fine details in order to separate all of these objects from each other. When they are clumped together in a bin, if you can't distinguish it, then it just becomes a big smudge, and it's hard to put your fingers in there and grasp something. And then in regards to SKU coverage, you need to be able to see all types of objects, to see a wide variety, regardless of color, surface quality. and things like that. And then, of course, as many of you probably have seen, when the objects are shiny, kind of chrome, reflective mirror-like type of objects, it becomes a huge mess. The point clouds gets lots of noise, and it's typically very hard to impossible to do. So that needs to be addressed as well. That's what we have done in Zivid. And we have lots of different features and specification to handle all of this. And I will just look at some point clouds to show you the effect. Okay, so let's recap the point cloud we saw from a consumer bin. And we did zoom in on that part. I asked you to pick one individual object. Let's look at how it should be. This is a point cloud from Zivid 2. And look at the speed. You know, this one took 400 milliseconds. This one takes 100 milliseconds. That's 4 times faster. And the quality is just widely superior. And if I'm a robot and I get this image, I can actually pick objects more reliably. And that's what's needed. That's one of the important things in order to get more robots out there doing more advanced picking. And this is the whole bin. And as you can see, it looks like an image from a cell phone, right? It's like as we want it to be. It's clear. And this is full 3D point cloud. Okay, let's look at shiny and reflective objects. A little more detailed look on that. So this is a typical image. There's a lot of cylinders here clumped together. And because of reflections and problems in the imaging, there's lots of artifacts and noise. You see that there's points here. They will do this. Yeah, I mean, to detect individual objects here is almost impossible because it's just noisy. And this is a typical thing you would see from most sensors that doesn't deal with these things. So in Zivid, we have something we call artifact reduction technology. And that's a lot of things, but what they do is that they try, the sensor try to look what's underneath here to understand the noise and get the real surfaces from beneath. And yeah, you can see the results. Suddenly it is possible to detect these shiny objects, and you can actually imagine that you could go in and pick them. And that is a huge thing in picking shiny objects in manufacturing. And if we look at the high-end laser structured light system we looked at previously with all the different artifacts we saw there and the low resolution, this was 500 milliseconds and this is 300 milliseconds with Zivid 2, and as you can see, the data quality is superior. Okay, we talked about detection. Now let's talk about picking and placing. So in any system, there's uncertainties. And the problem here is the representation of reality. So the system, the camera, it tells the robot, this is the reality. This is where the objects are located. But there might be errors in that representation. And that means that the picture the robot gets is not true. It's slightly off. And that error creates lots of problems, because when the robot then, directed by the camera, goes in to pick objects, it might crash or it might mispick. And that happens a lot, and it's very hard for even advanced system integrators to struggle with these things. So what we have done with the Zivid 2 is that we have minimize this error. So this is a groundbreaking performance of 0.2 or below 0.2 dimension trueness error. And it's not enough to have that number, that helps you, but that dimension trueness error needs to be not growing or become worse under temperature variations and under mechanical stress. So if the camera gets shocks or vibrations, that needs to be stable, or else things will start to degrade over time. So those two things we have taken care of in the Zivid 2 camera. And here is an example of a point cloud where the trueness is below 0.2, and then it is as it should be, and you can do detections and you can do picking in that point cloud. If there is trueness error, that means there is some scaling, rotation, and translation error, then you see that the red points here is what the robot actually see, but the gray is the correct one. Of course, this is exaggerated now, but it shows you the point that if I try to pick this object, I would go to the red here, but the object is actually located here, so then you get some problems, might be crashing, or you can mispick it, or you don't get it as accurate as you want. And if I can go back and forth here, you see the point. It's very, very important. And it's like these hidden things that you think maybe it's your detection algorithm that makes you crash, but it's actually the trueness of the camera that is wrong. So it's important, and we have solved it. Okay, so the last thing I want to talk about is the opportunities we have seen and our customers has asked for, and the market, we see the trends now, that more and more can be solved with on-arm solutions. On-arm solutions gives opportunities in regards to flexibility in what the system can perform. If you want to pick from several bins, or you want to use the same system to both pick and place, that can be done. And of course, the improvements you can achieve with on-arm solution, if you take image from different perspective, different positions, can be vastly improved, especially in regards to shiny and reflective objects, where the positioning of the camera can be it can be the whole thing actually. So our newest camera is very small, lightweight. It mounted on the robot, it doesn't restrict the robot motion, so you can continue to do advanced application while camera is on arm mounted, as you can see in the picture here. So to summarize, that the term of universal picking is not solved, and that is due to historical limitations in the vision system and 3D, and of course a lot of other things as well, but that's the part we are addressing. And detection is not the same as picking. So you need to be able to detect correctly, but you also need to have a true representation so the picking is not failing. And same for placing. And then at the end, the Zivid 2, a remarkable 3D camera, and it gives you the great flexibility and without any compromise on image quality. So that was all, and I'm happy to answer questions.